Welcome to the new lab course. The name of the lab is Production Automation Lab or Advanced Manufacturing Lab. So in this lab course, we will discuss multiple machine tools or processing equipments which lies on the floor of the Production Automation Lab in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, University of Engineering and Technology, Peshawar. A course code is mentioned, that is ME402L. It is 1 credit hour course and 3 contact hour course. Grading policy and lab course assessment will be done as per university statutes. Lab course card and weekly schedule is already been shared as a separate file in the Google Classroom. So you can download that file and you can check and read the contents. That's what we are going to cover week wise, and what are the different CLOs and PLOs which we will target in the particular or specific lab. Recommended books include Automation Production Systems, Computer Integrated Manufacturing by M.P. Grewal. Apart from this, you can go for the Google search and you can download multiple books or multiple PDF files where you can clear your concepts. Learning objectives of this lecture: at the end of this lecture, student will learn and know layout of advanced manufacturing processes lab, basic introduction to machine tools or processing equipments and its specification, technical specification, safety guidelines or safety precautions. Apart from this, we will also discuss how to draft lab report. So lab report should be drafted manually or it should be handwritten. So the figure that you are going to use in the lab report, that should be labeled as well as captioned. The title of the lab practical or lab experiment is Layout, Safety Guidelines and Basic Introduction to Production Automation Lab. Objectives include to know about the location of each machine tool or processing equipments in the lab. Second objective is to know what safety guidelines or safety precautions should be followed while working in the lab. Third is to learn the basic description of each machine tool or processing equipments and to note its specification. Next is to know about the basic relevant theory regarding numeric control or NC programming, basic component of the NC systems, NC motion control system, NC coordinate system, absolute and relative coordinate system. Also, we will discuss about the CNC, DNC, flexible manufacturing system, computer integrated manufacturing system or industry 4.0. So we'll discuss all these concepts in this lab lecture. That is lecture number one. We will also discuss what is the difference between CNC and DNC and NC and FMS and CIM. So this is the layout of the production automation lab located in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, University of Engineering and Technology, Peshawar. So you can see multiple machine tools or processing equipment lying on the floor. So you have to sketch the layout in this way. This is a sample, you can, but here I have already mentioned a note that you have to mention the location of the first aid box as well as fire extinguisher and exit door. Next is in the theory background, you have to mention the list of the machine tool or processing equipment, which include box Ford, MT2, CNC 3D cam, lathe and milling machine, IMCO concept mill 55, vertical CNC, 3D CNC milling machine, 3D CNC engraving machine, and then we have rapid prototyping machine and 3D scanner. So these are the machine tools which we will try to cover in this lab course in detail. Also, we will discuss the concerned software for each machine tool. So each machine should be covered in detail in this lab course. Next is basic introduction to production automation lab. So why we are studying this lab, as I already mentioned in the physical class, that In production automation lab, we discuss CNC based or program based automation rather than mechanical or manual machining. Then we have NC programming. So what is NC programming? You can visit or you can read the chapter number 7 of the recommended. So NC programming, so it is a form of programmable automation in which mechanical movements or mechanical actions of a machine tool, that may be milling machine or lathe machine, drilling machine or shaper and so on, which is controlled through alphanumeric codes. So alphanumeric codes basically include letters and numbers, and sometimes we include the symbols. Alphanumeric codes define the relative motion between the workhead and the work table or work part, as well as it also defines the other operational controls, which include coolant control, feed rate, spindle speed, strip size, and so on. NC concept was first developed in 1940, while the first NC machine tool or system is developed in 1952. Then if we talk about the NC component, what are the basic component of the numeric control systems? So it include program of instructions, which is basically alphanumeric codes. Second is MCU, machine control unit, which is responsible to guide the processing equipment. And third is itself processing equipment or machine tool, which is responsible to produce the part as per desired programming. Next is we have NC motion control system. Before discussing motion control system, I would like to discuss the NC coordinate system. So in NC coordinate system, it is very much important to have a standard axis system, which should be defined by the programmer. Programmer to have or to know about the relative motion, or to define the relative motion between the workpiece and the cutting tool. So if we have, as you already know, we have two different types of parts, prismatic parts and cylindrical parts. And we usually use most of the time Cartesian or rectangular coordinate system. So if we have non-cylindrical parts or prismatic parts, we basically use a 6 axis, which include 3 linear axes and 3 rotational axes, X, Y, Z and alpha, beta, gamma. But if we have cylindrical parts, which we usually machine through lathe machines or turning centers, our turning processes, and so there we use 2 axes, that is X axis and Z axis. So the part programmer must decide the origin location. If part is prismatic, then the center is taken as an origin. If not, it is not symmetric, or we can say if it is asymmetric, then appropriate point should be selected. Then next is we have NC motion control system. So in NC motion control system, as you already know, some operations are performed at the discrete location or at the point location on the workpiece, which include drilling, boring, spot welding, and so on. While there are some other operations which require a particular path to be followed, which usually follow a straight path or curvilinear path or circular path. For example, in lathe machine or in lathe operation or in milling operation or in planer or shaper operations, we usually follow the path rather than the discrete locations. So the path or discrete location is usually accomplished by motion control system. So we have two types of motion control system. One is called point to point, or we can say positioning control system. And next is continuous path control or contouring path control system. In point to point system, it moves the table or workpiece to a program location irrespective of the path followed. So as I already told, so in discrete, it basically moved the work table or workpiece to a discrete location where the particular operation is required. For example, we have drilling, we have boring operation, we have countersink or counterbore and so on. And point-to-point system or positioning system, program consists of series of point locations where processing action is needed. Second is continuous path system or contouring system. Here it simultaneously control and move the word table in two or more axes. It also control the tool trajectory or tool path relative to the workpiece. It can generate angular path trajectories as well as 2D or 3D contouring, etc. So you can consult or you can read chapter number 7 in the book that is being mentioned in the reference. So there you will get detailed information regarding the motion control system as well as the NC programming or NC component or NC coordinate system. Next is absolute or incremental positioning system. So another aspect of motion control is concerned whether the position is defined with respect to origin or with respect to the last point, which is considered as a reference point. So if you are considering last point as a reference point, it is what is called incremental motion control and incremental positioning. And if we are considering a particular origin, and from there we measure each and every point, or from that point we define each and every point. So then that system or positioning is called absolute positioning or absolute motion control positioning. Then we already know about the NC components. Next is NC, CNC, DNC, FMS and CIM. So what is NC? NC is numeric control. So mechanically automated systems, it was the first initially introduced system, and from there the CNC, FMS and CIM has been further developed in the revolutionary phases. So NC is initially automated machine and was developed to overcome human error. There parts, because human errors are there in the manual machining, so parts here, if we use NC to generate or to fabricate parts or to produce different components, so parts are usually more accurate, more uniform and more faster than manual machining. So the human error are common in mass production or repeatable parts. So here we using NC, we can minimize the human error in the repeatable parts as well. In NC, the motion action is controlled through alphanumeric programming. So as already told, in the NC programming, where alphanumeric codes or alphanumerics are used for the as a code to guide the system or to guide the processing equipment. Next is DNC. So DNC is what is called direct numeric control as well as distributed numeric control. So direct numeric control is basically the extension of NC, while distributed numeric control is the extension of CNC. So what is CNC? CNC stands for computer numeric control. If we talk about the comparison between NC and CNC systems, so in NC system, program tapes or punch cards were used and they are fed to the machine tool, while in CNC, part program is fed to the machine tool in the form of codes, not in the form of program tapes or punched cards. In NC, modification in the part program is difficult because program tapes should be changed if we want to go for modification or if we want to create or type a new program, while in CNC there is no tape used, so part program updation or modification in the part program is very easy, and we can do this activity using computer to update our program or to write a new program, while in NC you have to replace or you have to use a new program tape or punch card even for a small modification. And for a new program, definitely you have to use the new program tape or punch cards. The tape reader in the part program, but in NC, if you talk about NC, so tape reader or punching machine is the integral part of the MCU, while in CNC the MCU is basically consist of CPU, which include RAM, ROM, processor, hard disk, and so on. So in CNC, the MC unit is different from the NC. In NC, the flexibility of saving a program was not available, and each time you have to write in the program, while in CNC you can save multiple or billions of program in the, you can store it in the memory. Similarly, in NC, it is very difficult to import the kit files, while CNC this flexibility is there to import kit files and to create or to generate the codes and to dump those code into the CNC CAD machine, CAD CAM machine. In NC, because NC system or old system, it was introduced in the revolutionary phase in 1950, before just during the invention, just before the invention of the computers. So computer technology was not that much updated or was not that much matured during that time. So NC system has many drawbacks as compared to CNC. So in NC system, no feedback systems were available, while in the CNC feedback system is also there. NC system are not software driven, while CNC system are usually software driven. You can, nowadays you can see multiple softwares are there to run the CNC machine. While in NC there is no virtual simulation, availability of virtual simulation or visual were not available, while in CNC before dumping the program into the CAM machine, you can simulate your code and you can see the real time behavior or real time manufacturing in the visual simulations. So these are the basic differences between the NC and CNC systems. Then we have FMS, flexible manufacturing system. What is flexible manufacturing system and how it is different from the CNC and NC? So it is basically the updation or the modified shape of the CNC and NC. NC is totally been obsoleted. Nowadays we can see CNC machines which is used in the industry as well as in the different setups. So FMS basically accept the changes in the run phase in the process. Flexibility, what is flexibility? Why it is called flexible? So flexibility mean the ease by which you can change or you can make changes in the machine level or cell level or system level. So there the changes can be easily made as compared to CNC systems. Flexible manufacturing system consists of three entities. Basic entities are three, which include processing equipment, loading and unloading unit, transportation scheme, which is called MHS, material handling system, which include trolleys, automated guided vehicles, cranes, and so on. And then we have another entity which is optional, which is called storage and retrieval system. So if it is not been there still, we can call that system as a flexible manufacturing system. Then we have another concept which is called CIM, computer integrated manufacturing, which is nowadays we can hear the name Industry 4.0. So it is the advanced form of the FMS. So if we integrate the market or the management in the FMS, then it gave us a full package which is called computer integrated manufacturing. So this is the basic theory regarding the production automation. Next is basic introduction to machine tool or processing equipment. The first machine tool or processing equipment is Boxford MT2 CNC 3D CAD/CAM machine. It is a CNC based machine which can be operated in lathe mode as well as in mill mode. So it is 2-in-1. We can run this machine in lathe mode as well as in mill mode. We can make interconversion between these two modes. In CNC mode, it is operated by using the built-in software, and the name of that software is Boxford CAD/CAM application, which is used to run this machine in lathe mode and mill mode. It has different flexibilities which we'll discuss in this slide. However, it can also be operated in manual mode. As I already told, it can be run in the manual mode as well as in the NC mode. In lathe mode, chuck is used to claim the workpiece while turret is used to claim the cutting tools. So maximum number of cutting tool that can be claimed in the turret is 8. In mill mode, chuck is used to hold the cutting tool while the machine vise is used to hold the workpiece. It is one of the best industrial trainer which can be used for student demonstration for academic purposes. Next is software. If you talk about the software flexibilities or the software package, so it include CNC program writing and editing, 2D drawing package, visual simulation, material dimensions. It has tool library as well as material library and so on. So we'll discuss in detail when we will use this software for the programming or for the CAD drawing. So we'll access all these things. We will see how we can edit the program, how we can use the 2D drawing package, how we'll simulate the real-time operation, how we can enter the material dimension, how we can access materials from the library and tools from the library and so on. Here the link is also provided, which when you click on this link and you can see the description, the further detail regarding the Boxford machine. Next is IMCO Concept Mill 55 Vertical CNC Milling Machine. It is again 3D CNC milling machine, vertical milling machine, not horizontal. So it is a specialized machine for milling. The axis of the tool is vertical. Different holders are used to hold the tool one at a time in the specified portion. Built-in software is used to operate the machine. The software here used is MasterCAM to generate the codes and to do the operations. So why it is called IMCO? Because it is economical package. The software is MasterCAM A2 station with swivel DOM. You can read the technical data provided in this slide. Next is 3D CNC engraving machine. It is specialized machine for engraving. It can be operated manually by using the manual keys and can be operated by using built-in software. The name of the software is Dr. Engrave. You can read the further description. It offers versatile professional engraving, and the application of this machine tool or processing equipment includes: we can produce nameplates, name tags, signatures, awards, wood crafting activity, and so on. The software used for this machine tool is a built-in software, and the name of the software is Dr. Engrave. Remember, the software Boxford CAD/CAM software and Dr. Engrave both are compatible with the Windows XP. It is not compatible with the advanced version. So we will use virtual machine to install those softwares and to simulate our codes. Work area of that machine is 12 inches length, 9 inches width, and 1.18 inches in the Z direction or in the thickness direction or in the engraving direction. Material used which include acrylic. We can use acrylic material, plastic material, aluminum, and so on. Spindle speed is also mentioned. We can run this machine in manual mode as well as in software mode. So Dr. Ingrio software has interface similar to Microsoft Word, where you can type letters or numbers and you can send those number to the engraver and they will engrave those number on the workpiece. Fourth is a rapid prototyping machine, and fifth is 3D scanner. You can read the description. Safety precaution and safety guidelines mentioned in this slide, you can read it by yourself, because safety precaution or safety guidelines are very much important before using any machine tool or processing equipment, or before touching any equipment in that particular lab or in every lab. It is better practice to first read the housekeeping or safety precaution or code of conduct of that particular lab. So in this slide, the safety precautions are enlisted, so you can read it by yourself. It is very much important for the students to know about the operation or to know how to use the fire extinguisher. So we have code that is pass, pull the pin, aim the base, squeeze the trigger, and sweep. I request you all to watch the video. Multiple clips are available on YouTube where they are showing that how to operate or how to use the fire extinguisher. So this was all about the lab number one or lecture number one for the production automation lab. In this slide, the description has been provided, but it is not the part of the lab report. It is just to guide you regarding the figure captioning and figure labeling. So how to label the figure, how to caption the figure, it has been shown in this slide. You can read it by yourself and you can follow these guidelines to caption your figure as well as to label your figure. These are the poster which I will share in the Google Classroom. You can get further help, further it will aid you regarding these machine tools. This is the poster for the vertical milling machine. This is the poster for engraving machine. So I will share these posters on the Google Classroom and you can download and read it. It has technical specification in short description and regarding accessories and the control panel buttons and so on. So again, in this slide, a general lab safety chart, the instructions are being provided, are being shown in this slide. You have to follow or you have to ensure the housekeeping of that particular lab. This was all about this lecture. If you have any question, you are most welcome to discuss. Thank you.